We all want to be happy. Yeah? That's a basic thing that all human beings want. But we've got a thing called destiny. We've got a thing called karma. Yeah, that unfolds. Yeah? And for each of us, it is different for each of us of what unfolds. And nobody can change that destiny. Nobody can change that karma. That karma will just unfold. It's only good. But what we can do is we can lessen the pain, lessen the dukkha, lessen the suffering of that karma, of that destiny. Yeah? So it will still, we won't be able to avoid the normal things in the organism that we call the human being goes through. The various things in life that we've already been through. And undoubtedly will go through in the future in different forms, finally to death. There's no avoidance of that. But there is a way of lessening the attachment to it or the identity with it. And that's what yoga, that's what meditation is about. Only about that is lessening. Our identity with the ego, the small I, that we go through these things with, that goes through these things. So the good news, sorry, the bad news is that there's no escape into happiness. The good news is that is you can be free of the pain. I mean, that's what the Buddha was talking about. Buddhism was all about impersonal suffering. We're all human beings. So we all face the same things in life. But we can experience. Those things with a sense of dignity. And a sense of belonging to more than what the ego dictates that we belong to. So a sense of belonging to the whole. And yoga based on those boundaries. And so the I dissolves. And then there's a sense of lack of boundary. And a sense of lack of. This is a key one, lack of self-consciousness. You can measure yourself on that one. How much self-consciousness you've got is how much ego you've got. The less self-consciousness you have, the less ego you have. It's a good measure.